So this space used to be a tambakan. It used to be a bodega. When we saw this bodega, sabi namin, sige, itibag na lang natin para mas malaki yung space natin for the kids to run around. But then, we realized, because we've been watching Tiny House Nation, what if we just make it into a tiny house? So something that we can bring the kids there and then sleep over, and then it will be a fully functional space. Hi! Welcome to the Balea Tiny House! Actually, we didn't really have an inspiration. What we did was we tried to check what were the available items we have existing. So we used to have a sliding door that was used and worn out. So sabi namin, instead of buying a new one, let's just use that and then use it as a opening space. And then whatever furnitures we have, sige, let's just pull it in together. And then I think the only thing that we would be able to purchase would be the tiles or whatever important toiletries, ganyan. So basically, it's just to really be a living space for the family. The Balea Tiny House is only 18 square meters. So it used to just be a space, a bare hollow block bodega. And then we didn't know if there was any support. So what we did was we chipped off the corners and then recreated and replaced it with posts for foundation. And then also for the roofing, it just used to be a yero. So here, what we decided was we put a beam and then buhusan natin, after buhusan, strengthen it with supports and then make it as a roof deck. Just so mas mahangin lang. Basically, it was a concern for us to make sure that the house was structurally strong. My husband thought of the idea, let's call it Baleo. It means strong because it's situated in Old Balara, and Balara means strong also. So Baleo is like a baby of Balara, parang Baleo. Both of them means strong. So I think the struggle that we experienced when building the Balea Tiny House is the toilet. When we had a person putting up the plumbing system, I think he was used to having the usual shower and the faucet separately, or just one pipe and then connector na siya. So, of course, parang we wanted a little bit more minimalist and more modern, so we wanted it separate. So, he couldn't visualize how are we going to do that, because I think he was a very traditional plumber. But I think it was also a good problem because we were able to test if the plumbing system was really a good way of bringing in the water and, you know, disposing the water and the sewage. Most of the cost would be the labor. So more or less, we did around 200, around ganyan. I think max na yon. May mga furnitures na rin. So the bulk thing that we purchased after the labor would be the flooring, the tiles. Kasi we extended the frontage of the tiny house to have a platform just to make it look bigger. And we didn't expect that it would cost so much for the tiles. But other than that, all else of the furnitures are really recycled materials from the space of my dad's place or mga surplus shops. And even this couch, it looks so chic, but we only bought it from a surplus store for only 10,000. Genuine leather po siya. Whenever we're renovating, the first thing that we do is always change the furnitures. But if there's one thing that I would recommend is you change your flooring, because flooring makes a big difference to a space. And then next is the walls. So after that, when you have the right shade or the feel that you want for your flooring and for your wall, the furnitures will just blend in together. Balea Tiny House isn't just a space wherein you can rent as a overnight stay, but we want to make it as an experience. So we're pegging it around 6 or 6 to 8 with the cleaning fee already over at Airbnb.
Want to share your house and get featured? Email us at stories.onlygood@gmail.com and tell us about your interesting home story. For more videos like this, subscribe to OG and be part of the community.